The Denise Audio Sweeper plugin is like all Denise Audio plugins, a simple yet unique plugin in its approach. With Sweeper you can go from this to this. Stick around until the end where I will show you how. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel, a channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. The Sweeper is a dynamics frequency EQ, but not a dynamic EQ. It works somewhat similar, but it's very different. Let me show you how. The Sweeper works by sweeping the frequency spectrum with a high or low pass, from low to high or high to low. The sweeping reacts to either the input signal or to the sidechain signal you feed into it. You set a start and end point for the range of the sweeping, and you can select from a number of different slopes which can go from 12 dB per octave to 48 dB per octave. So 12 dB for a bit smoother sound and 48 dB will be the most drastic. And you can make it more focused and resonant by adjusting the resonance dial. So in this way you set up the sweeper as a kind of ducking compressor, but you use it by high passing the signal instead of ducking the entire volume. This will sound more natural than your standard compressor ducking techniques. And it's really easy to dial in envelope and wah-wah type effects with this plugin. You set the start and end point, slope and resonance, and you start using the attack dial. That is how quickly the sweeping reacts to the incoming sound. And with the release you set how quickly the sweeping falls back. With these controls you can make it more musical and more responsive. The way it reacts to the incoming signal makes it sound natural. The filter itself is also sounding really nice. There's no dry wet control on this plugin. Usually dialing back the resonance will do the trick. But if you want to blend in the original sound more, you have to set this plugin up as a send effect or duplicate the original track without the sweeper on it. One of the more unconventional ways is using this plugin as a sort of a subtle gate. This can work on, for instance, toms and snare drums. You set it to when the loud attack comes. The plugin opens its filter to sound normal. After which it closes, and with that it will automatically cut all high end, which is in this example the hi-hat. And what about using the sweeper to its absolute strength by turning in a bland synth into something exciting? Let me show you how. Here's the Minibit 8-bit plugin. Check my review here. Like this, it's pretty bland by itself. I programmed some velocity and changed the note length a bit. Let's enable the sweeper on it. I'll use the sidechain to modulate the sweep. Let's choose kick and it sounds like this. Now let's try hi-hat as a sidechain source. It adds an interesting movement. With a synth lead as a sidechain source, it sounds like this. And altogether it will sound like this. Here's before and this is after. Very powerful, and the sweeper adds a hell of a lot of life into this pretty bland synth. You get into the Roland TB-303 type of sound like this by only using the sweeper. Powerful stuff. I like the sweeper plugin. It does auto filtering with a good sounding filter. If you pair it with plugins like, for instance, Denise Audio's Guard Mode or Bad Tape plugin, check my review here, you can get into really creative sound sculpting areas. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that like button. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!